Let us look at another great son of India, another great leader of India. The next E, we know this man. Again, we are talking of cricket. We are a superpower. Aaj hum us waqt, us din pe jaate hain, when the seed, revolution, evolution of cricket, salab cricket ka utha desh mein. Anybody, sir? Absolutely right. Cricket moved from the big cities to the upcountry towns, and that heralded the revolution of cricket in India. 25th of June 1983, when India humbled the mighty West Indies. But even before that is over here. Turning point, Turnbridge Wells. And is this man another great son of India? Great captain or great leader of India? Yes? Kapil Dev Nikhanj. Born on the 6th of January 1959, he was made the captain, 24 years and 6 months. He writes in his autobiography, and the autobiography is what? Straight from the heart. Isme kya likhte hain? He says, I was made the captain. Only 3 people in the team were junior to me. Everybody else was senior. And he says, there were 3 ex-captains in the team. To take instructions from me was a problem. Mere se instructions lena nahi chahte. It was an issue because I was almost the junior most. And he says, nobody listened to me. And he says, we played bad cricket, and once we were playing against the Minnows, Zimbabwe. They had just got test status. And he says, we were reduced to 17 for 5. I looked around and people laughed. I said, let us do something serious. And he says, people laughed. And he says, then I said, I will not do the talking. My bat will do the talking. And out he walked, and it was raining 4s and 6s. 16 4s and 6 6s, 138 balls, and the score was 175, not out. Single-handedly, the match was won by this great son of India. And he says, after that day when I came to the dressing room, no questions asked. My word became the law in the dressing room. Semi-finals, we beat a very strong English team, and in the finals, we humbled the great, mighty West Indies. Clive Lloyd's West Indies, which takes a claim for being the greatest in the history of cricket. And again, we are talking of another E. Which E is this, friends? The third E. This E is edge, cutting edge. What does cutting edge mean? Cutting edge is skill level. Skill level of the leader should be one level ahead of his team members. A leader has got to be accepted. If we lead a team, I should be able to set an example for my team members. We cannot be non-playing captains. I must be an expert. I must be a master. People should look at me and say, can I become like my leader? Can I copy him? Can I imitate him? Can I emulate him? Can I replicate him? Can I duplicate him? Can I become like him? So self-upgradation, training, that is our responsibility. The buy-in of the leader also sets in. Otherwise, the leader is not accepted. Mentally, he is not accepted. Edge also means imparting the cutting edge to the team members, training them and making them better. If the training levels or skill levels are great, again, the team becomes unstoppable, unmatchable. Great son of India,